The Circular Economy Simulation Fashion Forward is designed for learners at all levels to learn about the principles of the circular economy, reducing waste in supply chains, and transitioning to new business models. Let's show you how it works. At the start of the game, you can choose the product line for your company. You may either run a company that makes trousers, shirts, and dresses, or a company that is active in shoes, bags, and belts. Although these two scenarios are different, they are of similar difficulty. You can also give your company a name if you wish. Before making decisions, you can review information about the circular economy and the environmental harm that the fashion industry is causing. The fashion industry generates 92 million tons of waste per year and is responsible for 10% of global greenhouse gas emissions, and only by moving towards circularity and tackling waste can this impact be reduced. Other industries face similar issues, and the circular economy principles practiced in the simulation can be applied to a wide range of companies. The How to Play page explains that in the simulation, you manage the design, manufacturing, and retail activities of a fashion company. Each year, you decide on actions across the supply chain in order to improve the company's circularity performance. Progress is measured by the Material Circularity Indicator Score, which in turn is made up of scores on recycled inputs, product lifespan, collection rate, and recycling efficiency. Additional performance measures include waste, greenhouse gas emissions, and operating profit. All these terms are defined on the relevant screens in the game, as well as in the glossary page. If the instructor has not given specific guidance on the metric to optimize during the simulation, then it is suggested to measure progress through the Material Circularity Indicator Score. The company you manage sells a range of products, both in its own stores and online. At the start of the game, financial performance is good, but there has not been much progress towards circularity or the development of new business models. When ready, move to decisions, where you first decide how much to spend on staff training and on research and development. You then choose a maximum of four initiatives from across the different stages of the supply chain: design, manufacturing, and retail. Decisions can be reviewed and revised in the summary and submit page before they are confirmed for submission. After entering decisions, the dashboard provides a summary of the company's performance as well as feedback on each of the initiatives that have been chosen. Charts show data on the Material Circularity Indicator Score, greenhouse gas emissions, and operating profit. The circularity dashboard shows progress on each of the components of the Material Circularity Indicator, as well as on waste levels. The emissions dashboard shows the company's greenhouse gas emissions and its electricity consumption. The business performance dashboard contains charts on revenues and operating profit and has an income statement that shows a breakdown of revenues and costs. Other tables show more business information, including details on the performance of new business models. After reviewing performance for the year, you make new decisions. Each year, new initiatives are added to the list, and these are clearly marked as new in the first year that they are available. After 5 years, you can review your overall performance in the dashboard and check the game summary to see an overview of your decisions and results for the game. Hopefully, you make great progress towards improving the circularity performance of your company, but remember that improving circularity and profitability at the same time is not easy. You can always play again to try to improve your score or to manage a company with a different product line. Enjoy the game!